All right, so to adapt music for the steel orchestra, you of course need to know the instrument itself, and that means that you need to know the ranges of each instrument. All right, now before you could even adapt anything, you first must select a song. And when you select that song, of course, the first time you listen to it, probably the second time you listen to it as well, you're just listening to that song for the purpose of enjoyment. But when you're trying to now adapt the particular piece that you're listening to the steel instrument, you have to do a different type of listening, right? And that is more of a perceptive listening. And what that means is that when you're listening to the song now, you're trying to hear what is happening within the body of the song. So that is just trying to, you're excluding the vocals because you can obviously hear that, and then you might exclude the bass, right? Why you would exclude those two? Because you can hear what is happening there and you already know where you're going to place those two voices, right? What you need to figure out is what am I hearing within the song that I'm listening to and where would I place it, right? So let's take a listen to Rihanna's Diamond, all right? And try to listen to the inner parts and see what is happening there.
Shine bright like a diamond. Shine bright like a diamond. Find light in the
Right, so the part before was obviously the introduction, her introduction. And from the time it begins, you're trying to study, okay, what am I going to do with that particular instrument? That particular introduction. Yes, it is her alone for the vocals, but how am I going to spread that out within the orchestra, right? So those are things that you start to question and ask yourself. So you could hear within this particular point that it is her using her vocals, then there is keys, and then there is the bass, right? And obviously there is a drum kit keeping a steady tempo there and a steady rhythm there, right? Right, and it just sounded like she now introduced strings within this piece right here, right? So she added something to her instrumentation. And the key is kind of doing something. Right? But it's very faint. Right, so you hear the strings are going on one particular note right there, holding it out, and then when the chord changes, they change too, right? So from all of that, you're trying to figure out, okay, I can hear strings, where would I want to put strings within the steel orchestra? So you're thinking about where would I like to place my strings. All right, and right here now she goes back into a verse. This is the second verse, and you could hear from before when the strings were in, the strings are no longer in there. right? So she's back to its original form as what she had within the verse.
Moonshine and my lake, feel the warmth, will never die. We're like diamonds in the sky. You're a shooting star, I see a vision of ecstasy. When you hold me, I'm alive. We're like diamonds in the sky. At first
it has something there that sounds like a very dark flute. Let me just go back a bit there. And obviously here your bass now is playing, they're just rolling there, right? So they're playing a lot of semibreves, and most likely this note is on the root of the chord, right? So your bass isn't doing much at this point. Even from the beginning to up to here, they aren't doing much. So you in yourself could decide, would I want the bass when I'm adapting my when I'm adapting this to the steel orchestra, do I want to keep it in its original form with what is happening here? Alright, then, so now that you've figured out, well, at this point, I'm hoping that you would have figured out, okay, I want my tenors and double tenors to play the melody, and the double tenors will harmonize with the tenors to provide that support in terms of the melodic lines for the verse and chorus. Or you could decide, listen, the double tenors will support the tenors within the verse, and then they will switch in the chorus and do something completely different to what they were doing before. But when we have that shift, we're gonna move it to the seconds, providing support to the tenors, right? That would have possibly meant that within your verse, your seconds would have either been strumming or playing again a bit of a counter melody to what is happening there. All right, then even when you're adapting this, you're gonna ask yourself, am I adapting it to sound exactly like this, or am I going to change it a bit so it sounds, I guess, a bit more calypso-ish or along the lines of soca? And if I'm going to do that, then what do I need to change about that, right? So most likely in that instance, you will be adding a strum to your adaptation, all right? But then you need to figure out who is going to strum. Am I just going to give the guitars and cellos to strum, or am I just going to give it to the guitars? How am I going to give it to the guitars? And if I'm not giving my cellos to strum, then what am I giving them? So when you have gotten an idea as to how you want to adapt a piece, the next thing that you really need to think about is the level of the players, right? Because that will determine how you take the music from its original form and simplify it for beginners. And if they're not at the beginner level, then you think about if I am assigned to an intermediate level, how do I adapt it then? Do I minor some complexities? Do I add some complexities to the adaptation? And the same thing for the advanced level as well. All right. So all of those things you need to think about. You need to know the instrument. You need to know the song. You need to know what you're gonna place where from the original song to the steel orchestra. And you need to know who you are adapting it for, all right? Because you can't give a beginner level orchestra the same thing that you would give to an advanced orchestra, all right? Now, once you figure that out, you need to figure out what you're gonna do for the introduction of your adaptation. Am I gonna use the same introduction from the original song? And if yes, then how am I going to place it within the orchestra? Is it going to be something that is completely unison, so everybody's playing the same thing, just at different ranges to suit the instrument itself? Or am I going to alter it a bit and pull something from the song to create an introduction? And if I'm doing that, then do I have my tenors and my double tenors playing the same thing there, but I have something different happening in my guitars, cello and bass, right? And if you have something different, you're gonna say, well, I got it from X, Y, and Z, all right? Or it could have been something that you listened to the song so much that you even started like putting your own bits and pieces of rearranging what is happening in the original song to create something a bit new but relative to the song to be within the introduction. All right, so there's a lot that you have to think about before even trying to adapt for the steel orchestra. You even need to think about what the tempo will be. Would the tempo be along the lines of the original tempo from the song, or do I want it slower? Do I want it a bit faster? And you're thinking about this too based on the level that you're adapting the piece for. The next thing that you're going to think about, you're going to say, all right, am I going to do it in the original key or will I change it? And let's say this is in a ridiculous key that has a lot of flats and sharps and you're going to give it to beginners. They might get a bit frustrated having to learn sharps and flats, right? So you might decide, okay, I'm going to simplify it a little bit. I'm going to change the key. I'm possibly going to give them something with one flat or one sharp or two flats and two sharps, right? So you pretty much think about all of that when you're trying to adapt a piece. So let's just take a look at my adaptation and even arrangement of this song itself. Right, so I'll just go ahead and play the audio for you before explaining what is written here. So, what I decided to do when I wanted to one adapt this song to the steel orchestra, I needed to figure out, okay, who is going to strum? Because there's no strumming in the original song itself. There's just a few chords, right? But I decided to actually use the chords that were given, but change it a bit, right? Because I felt like even though the song, the original song in itself, was focusing on mainly the vocals providing support to what Rihanna was singing, I felt like, you know, we could have done a bit more to complement what was happening, what she was doing exactly, all right? And that is why I decided that, you know what, I don't want to take away from what it is that she is doing. So I'm just going to have one voice strum and hold down the chords while the bass maintain pretty much moving between the root and the chords within the song itself, right? So the bass was actually providing some support to what the guitars would have been doing here, right? And if you look throughout the entire arrangement, you will just pretty much see that the guitars are the only ones strumming here, right? After the bass would have been providing support to these guitars here, I decided that, you know, the verse, I'm going to leave it in its original form. And when I say the verse, I'm talking about what Rihanna was singing, right? So her melodic lines, I left it the same. I also decided that, you know what, I don't want to put this song in cut time or anything like that. I am going to leave it in the 4/4 form, all right? And that was just a personal choice of mine, okay? So when I left this in its original form, I decided that I am going to have the double tenors harmonize with them, but for some things they're going to harmonize in thirds, right? But you wouldn't see the third happening throughout the entire piece, right? Because sometimes thirds can't work right through, so you kind of change it up a bit. Now this part here, I decided that I needed to provide some support between the cellos and the seconds, all right? So they're actually complementing at times what is happening with the tenors, all right? So you see here, they didn't start on this one, they actually rest, and then they came in here, all right? So they even provided that support right here. And of course, these notes here would also be related to your chord. Minus the sometimes some of the passing notes and so forth, right? So let me just play that for you there. All right, I'm also gonna slow it down a bit. So from that, you could already hear there's some sort of, they're saying something, we come in together, right? So here they start, and then we get here together, and then they speak, and then we come back and talk, right? And the talking is happening between your tenors, double tenors, and your seconds and cello. All right, because I found that within the original one, it was a bit empty for me, and I didn't want that emptiness, right? So I decided to change it up here because I was looking for something more. All right, so I'll play it again. And then it separates here now, where I want to strengthen this, right, by adding the seconds playing this octave lower, right? And then they also aid in the cello part as well, right? So you now start to find that the seconds are going in and out of what is happening within the tenors, double tenors, and the cello part, right? The bass can hold its own, and the guitar as well can hold its own. All right, then we get here, the conversation is still going on. So they come in here and provide the support again with this. All right, the tenors are talking here. So little things like these, you start thinking about within your adaptation, right? I decided that I'm not going to use any of the string parts that they have in the original song, but I'm going to use my own by pulling parts from the melody itself, right? So like even here, right? This is a part of the melody itself, all of this, right? Is a part of the melody that I decided to pull out and restructure it to one go in two different voices, all right? Because I was looking for a different texture between this and this and your tenor and double tenor. Now what I could have done as well, I could have actually give split the seconds. So I could have given some of the seconds to play this, but also strum to provide support here. But I didn't want the strumming to overpower my melody or any conversation happening between this section and this section here. Right, so you see this melody that was played here comes back into this here. All right, so yeah, you think about that when you're going to adapt your piece. And sometimes even when you're listening to your music, then you realize if something can work for steel or can't work for steel itself. All right, and yes, you can go ahead and change the feel of your adaptation. All right, and also think about whether it is playable for the steel instrument. All right, you can't sometimes give too much to, let's say, the cello section or the guitar section without providing some sort of room for them to breathe in there. All right. In my case, let's see where the chorus is. So that was A, and then the chorus would have been here. Right, and then in this part now, you see that how the tenors started playing what the cellos have, and it now became the double tenors and the double seconds are playing the same thing. All right, because the double tenor, each instrument, we have to understand too, each instrument in itself has its own unique sound, and when you're adapting it, you're also thinking about it live. All right, what I want it to sound like if this is going to actually be performed by a steel orchestra. All right, and sometimes we make the mistake of always giving the tenors everything and not utilizing the other voices within the steel orchestra. Right, so when you're doing your adaptations, please ensure that you think about the end product of your adaptation and what it is that you really want, and be able to explain what it is that you were looking for. All right, in my case, I wanted to enhance the melody by providing bits and pieces of counter melody, and by holding back the chords, as in not having the chords dominate the melody itself. All right, and I used the bass to support what was happening with my chords, so that was completely intentional. Yeah, with regards to the introduction, I decided to use Shine Bright Like a Diamond, and that was within the original song itself, and even in the introduction, right? So I just did that over and over, and then to end it, I just use a chromatic to get out of it and go straight into my verse. So if you listen to that, you'll hear it here. right? You will hear the tenor, so the tenors have it, double tenor, and the guitar in this case, right? Because sometimes you need to give the guitars a bit some variation to what it is that they're doing, because you don't want them to get bored too, right? This is it. Now, if you listen to that with a percussion, you will see how the feel of it is different to the original song, right? Because the original song, the drummer was doing something pretty simple. Right, I decided to do this. So I decided not to start with the any sort of percussion there until we got into, I believe it was the verse. Right, and I even decided to increase the tempo there too, right? So I changed the structure of what the drummer was doing to give it a bit more liveliness, right? Because for me personally, doing it at the original tempo was a kind of a bit of a drag, and I didn't want that drag. Of course, Diamond is something that you should be, some people are very excited about having that. So I wanted to create that excitement for this particular adaptation. Alright, so that was my adaptation and slight arrangement of Rihanna's Diamonds.